Do you know how to avoid base level filter for a particular visual? Because in general, when we apply base level filter on Power BI, it applies to all the visuals inside to that page. And it also refers to the same thing for report level filter as well. So we can do one workaround through that we can avoid this feature. We'll talk about this in this video. Stay tuned for that. Hi, I'm Mohammed Adnan, and welcome to my channel, Tech 18. Here in this channel, we discuss a lot about Power BI, Power Apps, Power Automate, SQL, Excel, YouTube, and a lot more to come. So if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. All right. So this is my sales analysis dashboard. Here you can see the report is filtered to sales territory by Pacific and calendar is 2012. And if you look at on the filter pane, we have filters on this page is, this is greater than or equal to 2012. So basically if I switch to basic filtering, I can see the data from 2005 to till date. And at least if you want to show all the data, we can use this one. But as of now, the requirement comes, we had to restrict the data from 2012 onwards. So the slicer is filtered to 2012. And if you can see on the drop down here, you can see only 3 years, 12, 13 and 14. And sales territory group is filtered to Pacific. So everything is fine. Now the requirement is we need to add the Q&A visual. Q&A visual is really an A visual. That's an important visuals. I really loved it. I have made a video about the Q&A visuals and its features. If you haven't seen that, just click on the link given on top of your screen. Now coming back here, I have added the Q&A visuals here on the screen so that it understands the data and give us the results using the natural language processing. Right? So for an example, these are the some of the key points it has given. But even though I just want to give by myself input as sales amount by region, for an example. So it gives me these other suggestions. So I'm selecting the first one and click enter. It gives me only Australia. The reason behind that is the Pacific group is filtered here. So I'm clearing this selection and I can see now everything is refreshing on the back end and this also is being refreshed. I can see all the values here. Right? So it means the Q&A visual has an impact of all the slices, whatever we have. Now let's check whether it is being affected by the page level filter as well. So instead of sales amount by region, I want to use by year. So it gives me value of fact internet sales by year. It gives only 2012. The reason is here we have filter of 2012. So I'm clearing this slicer as well. Now you can see 2012, 13 and 14 data. So the result also has an impact of base level filter. So the user is, I mean, the customer is happy with whatever we have done so far, but the only for the Q&A visual, they want it has to get all the data from the data set, whether it is from 2005 or 2010, whatever it is. This Q&A should not have an impact on base level filter or whatever the slices we have on the page. In order to do that, there is a workaround. The first thing is we need to select on this slicer and we can go with edit interaction, right? So we can just go to the format and edit interaction. And I want to disable this for the Q&A. So whatever I'm going to select now here for 2013, for an example, even though the background is being refreshed, this is will not have any kind of impact. So I made a video about the edit interaction as well. If you haven't seen that, you can also check out on the video description or on the link on the top. So coming back here, we turn this on again, and if I select to 2012, it filters to 2012, 2013, it filters to 2013. So that's why I want to disable this. So I disable this here. And reselect again to 2012. So it refreshes the data and give result for all the years. Now, halfway done. And another reason is we have to avoid this one. So if I click on erase symbol here, it also impact all the other visuals on the page. And here you can see it gives the data from 2010, 2011, 12 and 13. So you must see, I mean, you may think that now this requirement is complete. Actually, it is not, because I have selected 2012 here. And if I look at that value here, I can see the data from 2005, but that's not the requirement. This slicer has to show only from 2012 onwards, not from the beginning. So it looks like we have data from 2010 onwards itself, even though the calendar has 2005, but the data is available only from 2010 onwards. So by going on 2010 basis itself, so we have to hide these 2 years on this calendar. So in order to do that, we have one way is we need to copy this slicer and paste, as in copy and keep it on the page itself. Now, clicking on here, it will give only one value because it is being filtered by this one. So what I will do is just click on this slicer again and go to format, and edit interaction is already enabled. So I will just select on disable. So what I'm telling to Power BI is whenever the user select this slicer, it should not have an impact on this. And now after doing this, I'm going to select the value of 2012, 2013 and 2014 here. So three values I have selected here. And then I can see only 2012, 13 and 14 as of now, right? So again, I need to select on this slicer and the edit interaction again, and I have to disable this for the Q&A. So by doing this, what happens actually is if I close the edit interaction and if I look at this slicer, I can see only 3 years. It is back to normal. So basically what happens is this becomes a main page level filter kind of things as inside the slicer, and by using these selections we are affecting all the other visuals except the Q&A. And the final thing you need to do is you have to go to view and then selection pane, and you have to hide this slicer. Cool, right? So by doing this, the page is looks like as before, that we can have only 3 years as a filter, 2012, 2013 and 2014, and the report behaves as usual. And whatever the year I'm going to select here, it will not have any kind of impact here. This also applies to the report level filter as well. How can we do that? I'm going to selection pane again and bring up that same slicer. Selecting this slicer, and you have to go to sync slicer, and you can just enable these sync options here. If you enable these sync options and then you hide this, then it will going to affect on all the pages inside to that page. So wherever you go, the same logic will follow. This is cool, right? So the final summary is, so what are the steps we need to do is, first is clear all filters on page level filter or report level filter. Second thing is add the same filter value as slicer the page. Third thing is disable edit interaction to this new slicer with all other old slicers. And fourth one is add Q&A visuals if required. And fifth one is select all other visuals select all other visuals one by one and disable edit interaction to Q&A visual. And sixth thing is add selected value, I mean desired value in the new slicer. So these are the steps you need to do in order to build this logic. So almost everything is possible in Power BI. It's just we need to think about some workaround in order to build that logic. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed it, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. If you're not a member of our channel, just hit the join button to know in detail about it. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.